baby, 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 baby.
G-Zack. Nah.
Baby, I've been on the run, but I will never run from your love. If you feel on my dick, there's a gun. Not right there, just a little above. I value my relationship is forever, but I've been cheating on the drug. Broke up codeine in a new plug. Hit up hot rod pints, I need 2 of them. Purple Scotty in my lungs, smoking green. Chopper on me, I don't talk.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Indianapolis Police Department. This is not a test. At 3:10 p.m., Eastern Daylight Time, a squad of officers approached the Indiana State Building due to a rumor that a biological weapon was planted there. The bomb ended up exploding and releasing a biological agent into the surrounding area. It is believed that this is an act of terrorism, as an Islamic man was seen leaving the building a few minutes before the rumor spread. The symptoms of this pathogen include nausea, vomiting, fatigue, fever, headache, coughing, and sneezing. All residents receiving this broadcast should return home immediately and stay away from the Indiana State Building. Close and lock all windows and doors, turn off all heating and ventilation systems, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape, damp clothing, or damp towels. This matter is being investigated by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and the Federal Bureau of Investigation. Stay tuned for more information on this developing situation. This message will be retransmitted shortly. This is the emergency alert system serving the Indianapolis area. Normal programming operations have been terminated at this time. Stay tuned for more emergency information. This is an emergency situation.
bit lower.
We have to bend back to determine that it's not good.
We went
from
being like, I'm just waiting.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Pittsburgh Police Department. A hostage situation is occurring at the Pittsburgh Joint PPG Aquarium. At around 4:30 p.m., Eastern Daylight Time, four dangerous men entered the zoo and opened fire on innocent civilians, killing 20 and taking 45 people hostage. It is believed that these men are from the terrorist organization named the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, commonly referred to as ISIS. The Federal Bureau of Investigation has noted that a similar situation occurred in Indiana an hour ago where ISIS released a biological agent. This is a particularly dangerous situation. As a precaution, all residents receiving this broadcast are advised to stay away from the PPG Aquarium and Pittsburgh Zoo. No one is allowed in the area until the threat has ended. All residents within a 15-mile radius of Pittsburgh Zoo and PPG Aquarium are advised to immediately evacuate. At this time, close and lock all windows and doors, turn off all heating and ventilation systems, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape, damp clothing, or damp towels. Continue to monitor local media outlets for more information on this dangerous situation. This is the emergency alert system serving the Pittsburgh area. Normal programming operations have been terminated until further notice. This is an emergency situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Ohio National Guard. A hostage situation is occurring in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio. At 5 p.m., Eastern Daylight Time, three ISIS members have raided the museum and have killed 15 people and have taken 85 hostage. It has been confirmed that these people are members of the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria, as these two incidents have occurred in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania and Indianapolis, Indiana. At this time, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame has been put in lockdown until the terrorists are detained. No one is allowed in the area at the moment. All residents within a 10-mile radius of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame need to immediately evacuate. At this time, close and lock all windows and doors, Turn off all heating and ventilation systems, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape, damp clothing, or damp towels. Continue to monitor local media outlets for more information on this catastrophic situation. This is the emergency alert system serving the Cleveland area. Normal programming operations have been terminated until further notice. This is an emergency situation. Chemical hazard warning for Chicago, Illinois. This is a mass casualty situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Federal Emergency Management Agency. Do not turn off your device at this time. A mass casualty situation is occurring in the Millennium Park of Chicago. At 5 p.m., Central Daylight Time, a chemical weapon has been detonated at Lori Garden and is releasing a chemical hazard into the surrounding areas. The symptoms of this gas include nausea, vomiting, fever, fatigue, coughing, sneezing, and headaches. Intelligence has reported that an Islamic man had walked into the park, planting the weapon, and intentionally detonating it. The terrorist group named the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria have claimed responsibility for the recent attack across the country. All residents receiving this broadcast within a 20-mile radius of Millennium Park, you need to evacuate. All residents receiving this broadcast outside of the 20-mile evacuation zone should do the following: close and lock all windows and doors, turn off all heating and ventilation systems, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape, damp clothing, or damp towels. Continue to monitor local media outlets for more information on this ever-so escalating situation. This is the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Normal programming operations have been terminated until further notice. This is an emergency situation. Hazardous materials warning for Cleveland, Ohio, Indianapolis, Indiana, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and Chicago, Illinois. This is a mass casualty situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Federal Emergency Management Agency. Reports have come in that members of ISIS in these locations have intentionally spilled hazardous materials in those respective locations. As a result, a dangerous chemical reaction has occurred, releasing a chemical agent into the air. The effects of this chemical agent include nausea, coughing up blood, vomiting up blood, critical fevers, chills, and migraines. These incidents are attacks carried out by the terrorist group the Islamic State of Iraq in Syria. All residents within a 50-mile radius of these areas are being evacuated by the United States National Guard. When evacuating, grab the following: food, water, clothing, medical supplies, cell phones, phone chargers, toiletries, blankets, and pillows, and a battery-powered hand crank or weather radio with you. When evacuating, tie a colored towel to your door or mailpost to show authorities you have obeyed the evacuation order. If you need assistance, simply hold the towel in your hands, and authorities will evacuate them. If you are evacuating on your own terms, try to only take one car of family. Tie a colored towel to your door or mailpost to show authorities you have obeyed the evacuation order. If you need assistance, simply hold the towel in your hands and authorities will evacuate you. Everyone outside of the evacuation radius should do the following: close and lock all windows and doors, turn off all heating and ventilation systems, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape, damp clothing, or damp towels. Continue to monitor local media outlets for more information on this ever-so escalating situation. This is the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Normal programming operations have been terminated until further notice. This is an emergency situation. Civil danger warning for the United States. This is a mass casualty situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Federal Emergency Management Agency. At 6:35 p.m., Central Daylight Time, it was confirmed that the terrorists from the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria have improvised nuclear devices in their possession and have planted them in Pennsylvania, Cleveland, Chicago, and Indianapolis, and will detonate them if their demands are not met. As a precaution, all residents within a 200-mile radius of Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Chicago, and Indianapolis need to immediately evacuate or seek shelter in a fallout shelter immediately. Fallout is a radiological material found in most nuclear or radiological materials. Prolonged exposure to fallout will result in certain death. Fallout can spread miles up to a minute after detonation. When evacuating or seeking shelter, grab the following: food, water, clothing, medical supplies, cell phones, phone chargers, toiletries, pillows, and blankets, important documents, and a battery-powered hand crank or weather radio with you for your stay in the fallout shelter. Make sure your rations can last you 14 days. The Federal Emergency Management Agency has set up sanctuaries that can be found via www.fema.gov. Continue to monitor local media outlets for more information on this ever-so escalating situation. This is the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Normal programming operations have been terminated until further notice. This is an emergency situation. an administrative message from the United States government. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government. At 7 p.m., Central Daylight Time, the ISIS members in Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Chicago, and Indianapolis were killed in a shootout against the United States National Guard. Bomb squads and SWAT teams have arrived in the cities and defused the improvised nuclear devices. They have contained the chemical agents and weapons in Chicago, and they have implemented quarantine procedures for Indianapolis to prevent the spread of the new pathogen, now dubbed COVID-19. All hostages in Cleveland and Pennsylvania have been freed and will be returned to their homes shortly. All clear. You may exit your shelters at this time. Your government would like to thank you for your cooperation during this emergency. This is the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Normal programming operations have been handed over to state and local authorities, and normal programming has been authorized to resume.
This is an emergency action notification, requested by the White House. All EAS participants will follow activation procedures in the EAS operating handbook for a national level emergency. The President of the United States, or one of his representatives, will shortly deliver a message over the emergency alert system. Please stand by. Please stand by. Please stand by.
We interrupt your regular programming. This is a national emergency. Important details will follow.
This is an emergency action notification. All broadcast and cable systems shall transmit this emergency action notification message. This station has interrupted its regular programming at the request of the White House to participate in the emergency alert system. During this emergency, most stations will remain on the air, providing news and information to the public in assigned areas. This is WAMQ-TV. We will continue to serve the Chicago area. If you are not in this local area, you should now tune to stations providing news and information to your local area. You are listening to the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Do not use the telephone. The telephone liner should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. We interrupt your programming at the request of the White House. This is the emergency alert system. All normal programming operations have been discontinued during this emergency. This is WAMQ-TV. We will continue furnishing news, official information, and instructions to the Chicago area. If you are not in this local area, you should now tune to stations providing news and information to your local area. Do not use the telephone. The telephone liner should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government. This is not a test. Repeating, this is not a test. A national state of emergency has been declared. The four improvised nuclear devices have been detonated by the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria in the cities of Chicago, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, and Indianapolis. As a result, these cities have been tremendously destroyed. Even though the terrorists were incinerated by the fireball, a considerable amount of fallout is spreading throughout the area. All residents within a 200-mile radius of Chicago, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, and Indianapolis need to immediately evacuate or seek shelter in a fallout shelter immediately. Fallout is a radiological material found in most nuclear or radiological materials. Prolonged exposure to fallout will result in certain death. Fallout can spread miles up to a minute after detonation. When evacuating or seeking shelter, grab the following: food, water, clothing, medical supplies, cell phones, phone chargers, toiletries, pillows, and blankets, important documents, and a battery-powered hand crank or weather radio with you for your stay in the fallout shelter. Make sure your rations can last you 14 days. The Federal Emergency Management Agency has set up sanctuaries that can be found via www.fema.gov. The President is expected to deliver a message when he is in a secure location, which is expected to be in 5 minutes. Please stand. This is an emergency action notification. All broadcast and cable systems shall transmit this emergency action notification message. This station has interrupted its regular programming at the request of the White House to participate in the emergency alert system. During this emergency, most stations will remain on the air, providing news and information to the public in assigned areas. This is WAMQ-TV. We will continue to serve the Chicago area. If you are not in this local area, you should now tune to stations providing news and information to your local area. You are listening to the emergency alert system serving the Chicago area. Do not use the telephone. The telephone line should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. We interrupt your programming at the request of the White House. This is the emergency alert system. All normal programming operations have been discontinued during this emergency. This is WAMQ-TV. We will continue furnishing news, official information, and instructions to the Chicago area. If you are not in this local area, you should now tune to stations providing news and information to your local area. Do not use the telephone. The telephone line should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. This is an emergency action notification. All broadcast and cable systems shall transmit this emergency action notification message. This,
ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
My fellow Americans, this is a truly dark time for this country. As I speak, IEDs have been detonated across the country, a new virus is ravaging Indiana, and chemicals are choking the nation. Massive panic, fear, and casualties are occurring across this great nation. The cause of this is the evil organization known as ISIS. These gun have recently started massive terrorist attacks on this nation. They have even managed to get small nuclear weapons and bioweapons. They have violated multiple United Nations laws and have committed war crimes and crimes against humanity, such as chemical warfare, biological warfare, attacks on civilians, and wars of aggression. This is a very dangerous situation. My fellow Americans, do not worry. These bastards will pay tenfold for their treacherous actions. We will not let our image be tarnished. We will not allow them to extinguish the flames of democracy. But for now, please seek shelter in a fallout shelter in which the National Guard will lead you to. Do not leave until 14 days afterwards. If you are within Indianapolis, Cleveland, Pittsburgh, or Chicago, do not leave even after 14 days, as dangerous chemicals are in the area, and it will not be able to be contained. This may also spread the pathogen named COVID-19. Although these times may be dark, let me offer some words of calming. Psalm 34, 4. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. This ends my message for now. Good night, and God bless the United States of America.
That was a message from the President. We now return you to the emergency alert system. This is the emergency alert system. All normal programming operations have been discontinued during this emergency. Please stay tuned for further emergency information.